All right, teachers, students of Ferncourt High School. Welcome to our General Assembly for February 22, 2021. I know with all that is happening around us, it's a pleasure we can all come together on this virtual platform where we can praise and worship God in spirit and in truth. So we start with, raise me up, Lord, now I can stand on mountains.
Yet I'm still waiting in the silence until you come and still are with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. There's no life without a strong one. Each restless heart beats imperfectly. But when you come and fill my life with wonder, sometimes it seems I glimpse eternity. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up so I can stand a mountain long. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. Oh, I am strong when I'm on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be. Oh, oh yeah, more than I can be.
Amen and amen. All right, this morning to lead us in devotion is Mark Forrest, our music teacher here at Ferncourt High School. Morning, Mr. Forrest.
Good morning, sir.
All right, I'm hearing you loud and clear. It's your time now.
All right. Good morning, everyone. I hope you all had a lovely midterm break. For me, it was a bit strenuous, but I can cope with that. All right. One moment. All right, so this morning I'd like to start off with these songs before I get into anything else.
When the road is long and heavy, when it's dark and dark, see clearly, I will lift my eyes to the east from whence my help comes from you. When I come to the end of my soul, Father, carry me. Father, carry me. When I come to the end of my soul, Father, carry me. When it's dark and I can't see clearly, I will lift my eyes to the hills from whence my help comes from you. When I come to the end of my days, Father, tell me, when I come to the end of my days, Father, tell me.
All right, so our morning's lesson will be taken from Psalm 91, verses 1 and 2. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. All right. So based on the passage of, this is the word of the Lord, thanks be to God. Based on the passage of scripture that I just read a while ago, I would derive my theme to be, the Lord is my fortress. And with this theme, I have another song ready to match up with my theme. It's a song that one of my friends actually wrote and shot a video for it. Now, please pay keen attention to the words used in this song because they are actually a tour of strength sometimes when you find yourself in some sticky situations.
The water. Oh, na-na-na-na-na. The water.
Back to the war on me. See it on me, no, me no, you can't stop me. Now all around me, yeah, yeah, yeah. Back to the war on me. See it on me, no, me no, you can't stop me. In Chicago, me war on. In Chicago, me war on. In Chicago, under the war. No stop me. In Chicago, me war on. So what do you put me right on up there? What do you put me left on? Man, I shall praise to God all around the world, one different land. The one around me, yeah, yeah, yeah. But if you are on me, see it on me, no, me no, you can't stop me. The one around me, yeah, yeah, yeah. But if you are on me, see it on me, no, you can't stop me.
Still a fence to a wall. Throughout all the evil deeds, me stand tall. Hope that them are free, but I got me a call. Up on me knees, make the enemies fall. And one thing them don't know, say me cover joy, better them go. One thing when me sure, the wall is stronger than the one at Jericho. Oh, yeah.
The one around me, yeah, yeah, yeah. God put you all on me. See it on me, no, me know you can't stop me. Now what do you want me, yeah, yeah, yeah. God put you all on me. See it on me, no, me know you can't stop me. What if we tell you said the world that build around me can build around you?
All right, because of the interest of time, I won't be playing the full song, but you guys can look it up on YouTube.
But if me tell you anything I do, then he can do it.
You guys can look it up on YouTube and actually take a look at the full song. But moving forth, we know that we don't go into anything at all without prayer. So let's take a minute to have a word of prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
All right, amen. Now, going back to the theme, the Lord is my fortress. At first, I was going to say everyone should take a minute and think about what the term fortress means to them. Reflect on it. See how it has benefited you in the past and how it can benefit you in the future. But because of the interest of time, let's just go for it. So it is said that a fortress can be called a military stronghold, especially a fortified town. Now, a lot of students can reflect with this term fortress because of some of the games that they play, or you have us teachers, or you have the parents that can reflect with this because of some of the shows that we watch. All right, you have games such as PUBG, Fortnite, Call of Duty, Free Fire. Those are games that our students play, and I know because a lot of them always ask me about the game, ask me if I play them, and those games are built based on the foundation of fortresses, where you have to defend your fortress in order to win the game. You have the shows now like Into the Badlands, and you have another one, Game of Thrones. Those two series are two series that you have to defend your fortress from all outside attacks, all invaders, etc. Another definition of the term fortress is a person or thing not susceptible to outside influence or disturbance. Now, this is where we look to God to build to build his walls around us and protect us from the attack of the enemies, whether it be physical, mental, or even emotional. No, I'm not saying that we as persons, some of us believers of Christ, I'm not sure about everybody, but I won't say that all of us are, but most of us should be. No, for the persons who are, I'm not saying that you should run out and put yourselves in harm's way, because sometimes God actually allows things to happen so that we may learn a lesson from it. One thing I always hear from growing up is prevention is better than cure. Now, for the persons who say that they don't need a fortress or there is no need for it, you can also look to one of our great legends, a huge artist for Jamaica called the great Bob Marley, who sings a song which is based on his fortress. It's not a physical fortress. It is more of a figurative way. It is more in a figurative way. Now, this is the song that he used, because as we know that, as much as it's devotion, this week is also Jamaica week. So I'm also incorporating stuff from Jamaica within my session. Have many more artists there that actually speak about fortresses in their songs, such as Etana, Romaine Virgo, Queen Ifrika, and the list goes on. And even here, while I was thinking a while ago, we have a national hero. Well, all our national heroes are toys of strength, but one in particular that I want to speak of is Marcus Garvey. Because back in his day, he was a tower of strength, also known as a fortress, for all the black people that were around him. And this is a quote that he said, "Up, up, you mighty race, we can accomplish what we will." Now, I know that that phrase still goes on in our everyday life right now, because a lot of us, when we get under some types of pressure, such as racism and a lot of those things, we look to that phrase to take us out of that problem. We look to help us out. It frees our mind. And that now is an emotional fortress, whereas we actually dive through that now just to make ourselves feel better. But in the interest of time, I'm going to close off now with one final song. And this one is leading up to the Jamaica Day seminar.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Cool breeze, evergreen trees, land of wood and water. It's just the place that you always feel free, where you hustle just to make your paper. It's just the warm, the calmness, the love, the affection that we all depend on as a real Jamaican. No war, no stealing, the land needs healing. Wave your hands in the air. earth. Yes, it's a yummy thing. Just to warm the calmness, the love, the affection that we all depend on as I reach a maker. No one no feeling, the land needs healing with your hands in the air. Yes, it's a yummy thing. Tourist resorts, welcoming hearts, people traveling by plane and cars. Look at the rivers and seas, respect to the greater kings. Jamaica has a lot to offer. No blood, no fear, scatter. Just peace and love, no fear, gather. So listen to this and your heart. It's just the warm, the calmness, the love, the affection that we all depend on. As a reach of Jamaica, no war, no stealing. The land needs healing. We have your hands in the air. Just to say, I'm reaching. Just the warm, the calmness, the love, the affection that we are.
All right, and that takes me to the end of my segment. So, Mr. T, back over to you.
All right, thank you, Mr. Forrest. As I said, we all have our different skills and talents. Music is one of your skill and talent, and use that to share the word of God. Thank you, Mr. Forrest, for your presentation this morning. All right, it's now 8:34, can't keep any longer. But this week is National Student Council Week. You will hear about activities in celebration of Student Council Week. I know the Student Council are planning an activity this Wednesday, so you will see the poster around. Jamaica Day is this Friday. As soon as we get the information, we'll share it to your form teachers who will then share it to our students. But this year, you know, it's going to be a virtual one, virtual Jamaica Day. So I want to remind you that to observe the COVID-19 protocols at all times, wash your hands, sanitize, wear your mask. When you're interacting with other persons, ensure they wear their mask, especially when you're moving in the public area. Protect yourself. That's the only way we can control the spreading of COVID-19. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you on Friday.